All right, so I thought I'd just do a real quick video on how to verify Electrum downloads using GPG. And as I've written here, this is probably the most important thing you can learn to do if you're using Electrum, and especially if you're using Electrum without a hardware wallet. The reason why you would learn to do this is it allows you to make sure your wallet is genuine. And on the few phishing Electrum websites I've seen, simply knowing how to verify the download would have prevented you from being impacted by that hack, being phished, and potentially losing your funds. So it's a thing that's worth learning to do. It takes like 15 minutes to get it set up, and once you've done it, it seriously takes like 1 minute to verify the download each time. So it's totally worth doing. Once you've got it set up, it just works. All right, so the steps to do this are really straightforward, and I'm just doing this for Windows because I think that's what most of my viewers are on. And we're just going to use a program called GPG4Win. So we're going to download that, and we're just going to cheap out for the purposes of this video, but I'd definitely recommend considering sending them a small tip if you're using their software. And for the sake of completeness, we're going to check the integrity of this package as well, just to make sure you're not on a fake GPG4Win website. So just while that's downloading, if you just click on Check Integrity, what you're going to want to do is it's going to open up this tab here, and you're going to actually want to take note of this information here. And the thing is that when you go to run this installer, a Windows UAC prompt is going to come up, and you're not going to be able to read this. So you will need to write down some of these details, and I'll show you the ones in a minute. But because I'm running this on a separate computer, I can cheat, and I've got it written down just here. That's finished downloading now, so we run the installer. So normally most people just click through yes here and not read anything, but what we're going to do is we're going to say show more details, and we're going to say show information about the publisher's certificate. So if we now click on the details tab here, we can actually see that the serial number of the certificate matches the serial number off the website that we were looking at. And we can also verify all the other information as well. And Windows would actually chuck a wobbly if the certificate wasn't valid either, because it's actually been signed in the same way as a certificate for a website that you're visiting using HTTPS. So we're going to say yes, that all checks out. So we don't need that information anymore. We can just say next. We don't really need to worry about anything other than the defaults if we're just using to verify downloads for things like Electrum. So we just install wherever we like. And there we go. Once it's done, we can just run Cleopatra and we're good. So it's time to go download ourselves a copy of Electrum. So we're going to download the Windows version. So we'll download the installer. So I've just started downloading the installer, and there's just something here that's really dumb behavior for Microsoft Edge, and it reminds me why I don't actually use it, which is if you click to download the signature, save target as, it looks like it wants to save it just as a PGP file, but if I go to hit save, it actually prompts to overwrite the exe, the actual installer, and if I click yes, it'll do it. It'll just blow the installer away. So you might have to save it as something else and rename it to match if you're using Edge, or just use a better browser like Brave or Chrome or Firefox. Now, the other important thing to see is on this page, it says that sources and executables assigned by Thomas V. So what we want to do is we want to save the target for Thomas V, which is his signature. All right, so we've got all our files downloaded now. So what we're going to do, once you install GPG4Win, you'll notice that when you these files now have this icon, and when you right click on things, you've got this new context menu, which is more GPGEX options. And we just want to say import keys, and if we minimize everything else, we'll notice that we now have the certificate import result from Cleopatra. If this is just open, it won't jump to the front and grab context. We can say OK. And it says, you have imported a new certificate. Do you want to mark it as green to be certified? And we want to start this process now. Yes. To verify the certificates, you first need to create an open PGP certificate for yourself. You only need to do this the first time you install certificates into this software. So from now on, if say you're wanting to verify multiple different wallets and things, you don't need to go creating a new certificate for yourself every time. So we're going to say yes. This key pair we're creating is just something that lives on our local computer, so it actually doesn't matter what details you use here. It's also going to prompt us for a password. Again, this is just for your own local computer, so we can call that password. I do love the fact that the word password as a password has 80% quality, but never mind. There we go. But look, we'll just take this one anyway because it's a demo video, but definitely choose a better password yourself. So what we want to do is we want to verify these three keys for Thomas V. Now, just before you hit verify for the Thomas V key, you're just going to want to check that the fingerprint is correct. So just when we go to import the key, we can see that GPG4Win is giving us the fingerprint, that number there starting with 669. And if we look at the documentation for Electrum, that is electrum.readthedocs.io, we can see the fingerprint that we're looking for, and these two things need to match. And this is important just because it is possible that a phishing site will have a different key that they want you to download, or it's possible that even your browser or the network you're working on might be compromised in such a way that they'll give you a different key. So this is the way that you can make sure that you are getting the correct key. So this fingerprint starting with 669 and ending with 0E6 is correct as of July 2019. But yeah, just keep an eye on the Electrum documentation if that changes in the future. It's also worth noting at this point that you shouldn't just import and certify any random keys you like, in that you do want to be a bit selective about choosing and telling WinGPG about who the keys are that you want to trust to be signing the software that you're using. We can certify it just for ourselves, not for everyone on the computer. And now it's going to ask us for the password we just made before. Finish. All done. So now if you look into Cleopatra, you'll see we've got the key that I made for me. We've also got the one for Thomas V. Now once that's been done, we can just close that. All right, so I've just turned on file extensions on this computer. So what you can see we've got there is the Electrum setup file, and then this is the download signature. So if we just right click on Electrum now, we can just go more GPGEX options, and we can just say verify. It'll sit there and think about it for a minute, and bam, it's all green, all happy. This signature was signed by Thomas V. And I'll just show you what it looks like if you try and verify an actual unofficial version of the download as well. So what we've got here is we've actually got two versions of the Mac OS downloads for Electrum. So this 3.381 is the one from the official website. So if we just say verify, it'll sit there and think about it, just like the one I just showed you for Windows, and it's all happy. Now, this 3.371 is actually one I downloaded off a phishing site from my previous videos. And if we go to verify this, it'll sit there. And this is verifying against the signature that was on the scam website. And actually says it is invalid. Bad signature. This signature you have is, and this file that goes with it are not valid. They don't match. So this has not been distributed by the official Electrum team. You need to delete it. Not just ignore it and install it, and go to electrum.org and download an official copy. So the last thing I'll show you is the error you get if you try and verify an Electrum download but actually don't have the right developer key imported and trusted in WinGPG. So this is the screen that you'll get if you haven't imported the keys that were used to sign this particular version of the .exe file. Depending on what a scammer is doing, it's possible that you might get either the red verification failed or the message that you don't have the keys that we used to sign the file. So you really need to be looking for that green verification everything is okay result. So there you can go, and as you can see, once you've got those keys imported and installed, it's really just a two-click process to verify, download, and make sure it works every time. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Just hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make to help people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. Or if there's a question you'd like some more information about or a topic you'd like me to cover in the future, just leave a reply.